Hello and welcome to this episode of MakerBox Mondays. Today we are going to have a look at a filament from Keen Village Plastics called Glow in the Dark Green PLA. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is like a light green color when you have a look at it in daylight. And it looks pretty cool. But let's look at the label and see what it says. So here they say glow in the dark green PLA. Print temperature is normal PLA settings, 195 to 215. And otherwise normal PLA settings. And here they say glow in the dark filament is abrasive. And you really have to be careful. If you have a copper nozzle, it's gonna be ruined for sure. Glow in the dark filament is really abrasive. So a harder nozzle is advised, highly recommended. It's gonna ruin your nozzle otherwise. And here they say a high quality PLA filament loaded with glow in the dark filler for long bright green glow. And I try to put this in the sun and then into darkness and it sure glows in the dark. And also with my UV light that I use to cure my resin printers. It works quite nice and it's close in the dark. It's difficult to see maybe here in the studio. I have all the lights on, but it works. So let's have a look at the prints. So here's the maker coin. That was coming out excellent. A little bit difficult to see on camera maybe, but print quality is really really good. Here's Sir Lazelot, absolutely no issues, turned out excellent. Just printing at 210 degrees C, it was coming out excellent. Also Mr. Belly here, looks pretty good. Overhangs here have a tiny amount of drooping, normally this model has. It looks really smooth and good. Here's the Otis model by Gareth. No stringing here. If there's a issue with stringing, I get stringing in this model, but it's working quite well. Here the overhangs are looking pretty good. It's really bright, bright colored on camera, but it looks really nice. So those were the prints I did with the glow in the dark filament from Keen Village Plastic. It was really nice filament to print with, but like I said in the beginning, make sure you have a hardened nozzle. I was using the Nozzle X from E3D on my Prusa printer. But this will be it for this video. I thank you for watching, and if you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please subscribe and ring that bell and leave a comment and a thumbs up and all that. But for now, thank you for watching.